You got to do the work to feel happy. And you deserve to feel good. You deserve, I've said it before, you deserve to give life your best shot. Hello, my friends, and welcome to the Depression to Expression podcast, yet another episode. Scott Ste Marie here, your host and coach, and today we're answering the question, the complex yet simple question, why is it so easy to get depressed? Why is it so easy to feel depressed? And why the hell is it so damn hard to maintain a certain level of happiness? To feel content, to feel happy, to feel joy. Walking down the street, seeing people smile and shit, you're like, what the hell's wrong with you? What's there to be happy about? It's COVID, it's lockdown. We're on Earth spinning in the middle of the universe and we're all gonna die. Why are you smiling, man? Okay, let's answer the question. So why is it so hard to maintain and feel happy like these people we see on social media, living their lives, pretending like we're not all going to be in a coffin one day or cremated and not exist anymore? Salute the babies. They are the future. They are here to replace us. We're not here for that long. And you wanted like an uplifting episode where I'm just talking about dying. But listen, man. It's quite simple, okay? Our minds are programmed for negative emotion, okay? We're more likely to remember a negative experience, feel negative emotion than positive emotion, or remember positive experiences. You know this because you're still thinking about that dude that bullied you in elementary school and called you fat. You can't get over it. You're still thinking about him, aren't you? That time, oh my gosh, that time in high school, you got embarrassed in public, everyone looked at you, face got red. Oh, what a fool you made of yourself. And of course, you've created this bubble of protection, right? It's a mechanism. It's a survival mechanism. Now, because if we remember the times where we felt embarrassed, fearful, sad, under extreme stress, we have to remember that so we can avoid that shit in the future. All right, if you know that there's a lion hiding in the bush thousands of years ago, if you knew there was a lion there, you better remember where that lion was so when you're going to pick some berries, you can avoid that baby. Avoid the lion. Okay? So we're prone and we're programmed to actually remember negative experiences and kind of push aside positive ones. All right, so this happens a lot during meditation for people. The thoughts that come up, it's not like, I'm the best, life is good, this is a cool, fun moment. No, of course not. When our minds kind of are let to do what they like to do, which is simply think, the thoughts aren't useful. This is boring. Why am I meditating? This is a waste of time. I could be doing something else. Life is weird. Life is scary. I wonder what other people think of me. Right? So the mind isn't always our friend. In fact, most of the time it's not. Your brain was evolved and designed, quote unquote designed, to help you survive. That's the meaning of life. You want to know the meaning of life? Alan Watts said it best. The meaning of life is just to survive. That's it. What, are you reading self-help books trying to figure it out? You read the Bible, didn't you? You're reading the Quran? What are they saying? That's all it is. I hate to break it to you. There's no special meaning. It's just to survive. That's it. And you're doing it, which is pretty awesome. So why is it so easy to get depressed and feel negative emotion? Well, because that's what the brain does. So the secret here, my friends, is that happiness takes work. That's the point. You think you can wake up and just feel happy to be alive? This is rare. And what actually happens is some people have a higher baseline of overall happiness than other people. We know this, okay? You know people that can just have this zest and this optimistic view of life, right? Like the guy smiling down the street during COVID. And it's locked down, but he's still so appreciative and grateful for his life and to be alive. Just grateful for existence. Like there's people that genetically just have a higher baseline of happiness, okay? Other people, maybe people more prone to depression, anxiety disorders, We got to work a little harder. Is it fair? Absolutely not. Life isn't fair. It's not meant to be fair. It's not meant to be easy, of course. We're only programmed to survive. So we're not programmed to be happy. Life's purpose isn't to be happy. This has happened. When was this actually a thing? When was this discovered? When did someone say that life was actually meant as this happiness and this journey of hedonism? It's bullshit. It's not. But we want to make it that way. So if you want to make it that way and experience more positive emotion and have some fun in life, you got to do the work, baby. You got to. Or else, just like me, I can sink into depression in a thought. Oh my gosh, I'm going to have some chocolate today, sit on my ass, not do anything, and just think about the worst things that have happened to me since I was born. How do you think I'm going to feel? Oh, depression's like, hello, Scott. Oh, thanks for welcoming me back, man. This is going to be great. Be prepared not to sleep and feel terrible. So you want to do some work. You owe yourself it. You really have to develop this sense of first of all, being realistic about, okay, this is the way the mind works. This is what it's doing. Cool. That's the beautiful thing about mindfulness and meditation, is to be the observer through that. Be the witness of how the mind works and what a thought is. It's not you. But then develop this sense of self-respect here and say, you know what? No one's coming for me, and it's me. It's my responsibility. It's up to me to change. No one can change for me. No one can do the work for me. If I don't want to feel depressed, I better figure out a way not to feel depressed. And it has to go beyond maybe going to a psychiatrist, going beyond WebMD and checking symptoms. It probably has to go beyond taking medication. Everyone's different in this way. What do you need to do to feel better? What do you need to do? What work do you need to put in place so feeling depressed isn't as easy? It's not as easy to get into that slump, right? How can you increase that overall threshold of depression so your tolerance for negative emotion is a lot higher? That's the point. How do you increase that threshold, increase that resilience? Right? So this is what happens. As kids, we're not resilient at all. That's why you think to that person that called you fat in elementary school, your life was over. It's like, holy shit, I must be fat, I'm worthless, someone else called me this. It's like no self-confidence, zero threshold for negative emotion, and we completely collapse under our own thoughts. You got to build some resilience, right? You got to build that threshold up so when someone calls you fat now, well, what do? You're not going to collapse. You're not going to have to call in sick to say something bad happened. It's like when I used to work at Twitter. I remember in 2016 when Trump was elected and a bunch of people called in sick. They're like, I just need to work from home today. Trump's president. Oh my God, how am I going to live? Meanwhile, they're working like for one of the best tech companies, earning an amazing salary. You privileged ass. Right? You know what I'm saying? So we got to build some tolerance up, some emotional intelligence, get to know ourselves a little better, right? Not put up a wall of defense against negative emotion, but take it for what it is and learn to work through that, navigate through that, get to know our bodies, get to know our minds, man. So a lot of us are dealt a pretty shit hand when it comes to genetics, right? Right? This is a pretty big role when it comes to depression, anxiety, schizophrenia, psychosis is... A lot of it's a genetic factor, and if we look at dementia too and Alzheimer's, it's like, man, it's tough for people out there. I feel for those people. The stories I've heard from friends of mine and their dad going through a really tough time with Alzheimer's, oh my God. It's tough. It's tough. Now, a lot of you listening are pretty young, right? So you have the benefit of looking far into the future and figuring out who you want to be, how you want to feel, what you want to do. You got time to build yourself up, to increase that tolerance, increase that resiliency, work on your mind and body. So it's not so easy to get depressed. You can acknowledge that what the mind is programmed to do, survival, But it's not fighting against that. It's working with it and then increasing that happiness as we go, right? So listen, why is it so easy to get depressed? I answered it a million times in this episode, but you got to do the work to feel happy, and you deserve to feel good. You deserve, I've said it before, you deserve to give life your best shot. And you know what? Life demands that from you. Life wants that from you. Whether you believe in God, God wants that from you. Other people want that from you. The world wants that from you. You got to give it your best shot. People want to see you do your best. We're on earth for such a brief time. So brief. Just a little spark in the timeline of the universe. In the timeline of even humanity. We're just a little brief flame. Is it better to burn out than to fade away? I don't know, man. That's Neil Young. But you got to do the work. Now, with that being said, you know there are no ads on this podcast. There's no ads. What am I going to make? $100? The hell is that going to do? It's just going to annoy you. But I'll tell you what's a really, really good use of your hard-earned money. All right? I'm not one of these guys that wants to sell you bullshit that doesn't work, and I'm going to sell you something so you can get abs in 14 days or end anxiety in a weekend. No. But if you're looking for tools that last a lifetime, if you're looking to overcome anxiety and depression, resolve these things, and get to know yourself on a deeper level, if you want to build that resiliency and tolerance to negative emotion, well, man, oh man, I got two options for you. Two options. I got three options. One, go to WebMD, look at all your symptoms, and get some pills. That's option one. Totally cool if you want to. Nothing against medication. You know I'm not for it or against it. Whatever works for you. So you can do that. Go to your doctor. If it's really severe, like, I'd actually recommend seeing a medical professional, okay? A psychiatrist, psychologist, right? If you want to talk about, just express some things, okay? But if you're like very functional and you want to just add some mental health tools to your toolbox, because that's where I was, right? Very level, but I'm like, I need some more stuff. Well, you know my story of being on antidepressants for over a decade, and I developed all of these tools that I used for years and years and years. So eventually when I went off, I was very successful in doing so. And I put all of that into a course called the Conquer Anxiety Course, which actually is beautiful for if you're dealing with depression too, because very similar tools in the way the body functions too. This will work wonders for you. So if you want to join my Conquer Anxiety Course, the link is in the description. It's called conqueranxietycourse.com. And you'll be added to my email list, the wait list. So when I open it up very soon, you'll be the first to get access. All right. It's like 8 hours of video instructions. It's me. I'm chatting with you. You get to join our community on the app Slack. You get to chat with me, a bunch of other people. There's bonus modules. It's awesome. And I really, really hope to see you there, because talking into a microphone is cool. And I hope you like listening to these podcast episodes. There's so many. Scroll down. You know that, right? And share this with your buddies. Share this with your friends. Hey. Write a review on iTunes. But this is all fun for me. But the really fun part is when I get to meet you. That's like the thing I love doing. That's the 7 years on YouTube and building an audience and talking about mental health. Like meeting actual human beings, that's what I love to do. That's why I started public speaking and going to schools and corporations. And that's why I started coaching and making that public, because I want to talk to you. Your individual needs, your psychological needs. I love helping you out. I love tweaking your routine. I like sharing my story. I like listening to yours. Through my coaching, what I've realized, my friend, is a lot of people, including myself, you know, they'll be like, Scott, you know, I don't need any tools, man. But I want to talk to you every week, and I just need some reassurance in my life. I'm like, oh my God, me too. It's like, I just want to talk to you about what I'm doing. I'm doing this, I'm doing that. And I just want someone to tell me, like, good job, and you're on the right track, and life is tough, but you're going through it. Humans need that. And during COVID, a lot of us aren't getting that from our relationships and coworkers and things like that. So the option number one is WebMD. Option number two is the Conquer Anxiety Course, conqueranxietycourse.com. Or you can go to conqueranxietywithscott.com and book a coaching call with me. It's absolutely free. We get to chat for 15 minutes and see if you'd be a good fit for coaching, for us working together one-on-one. Again, I'm not going to sell you anything. I'm not going to ask for your credit card, okay? It's none of that bullshit. I just want to have an honest conversation. Empathy's involved. Compassion's involved. Because I know what it's like, man. That's what's different. That's why really hard for me to get involved in therapy, because it works wonders for so many people. And it's the best thing ever. But I always wanted someone who's been there, who can relate. I know what depression, anxiety is like. I know what it's like throwing up from anxiety, not being able to sleep, wanting to be inside your body, but you feel completely outside of it. I know the heaviness of the world when you get consumed with depression. All right? I know this episode was just like, yeah, it's really easy to be depressed. We're programmed for negative emotion. I know. But please check out other episodes if you want some encouragement and for me to get really real about depression, how it takes over the body, the mind, the fucking soul. It goes deep. It gets heavy. I know the feeling when the world is just too much. We're taking an inhale is painful. All right? If you're feeling low, man, and you clicked on this video because it had the word depression in it, maybe you discovered this podcast because it said depression, man, you keep on going. You get the help you need. You get the help you deserve. You got this. And if I can help you any way on your journey, if we're a good fit, then I'll be happy to do so. If not, I'm happy to share more resources with you. But, you know, stay strong. You got this. Keep being you. And if you're feeling low, if you're feeling these negative emotions, just be like, hey, well, body, thanks for helping me survive. And now I got some work to do to increase that threshold and that level of happiness. Love you all so much. Thanks a lot for tuning in. And I'll see you in the next episode. Stay strong. Keep being you. And don't forget to express yourself.
Bye.